Welcome back. We will now discuss a number of converging lines of thought and research with respect to value-sensitive design. First, an important step in this line of thinking was a seminal paper entitled "Do Artifacts Have Politics?" in 1980 by Langdon Winner, which drew attention to the fact that values can be incorporated in artifacts and shape the behavior of people. His illuminating illustrations of how values and political views and power embedded in technology may shape and constrain the actions of people were very influential in thinking about the ethics of design of technology. The example that captured everyone's imagination was that of Robert Moses' low-hanging overpasses. The famous architect and urban planner Robert Moses designed the construction of overpasses on New York parkways low, so that white middle-class car owners could easily access Jones Beach, while at the same time preventing buses from the poorer black neighborhoods to pass under. Indirectly, the overpass functioned as a racist border mechanism separating the wealthy from the poor black New Yorkers. There has been some controversy about the historical accuracy of this case, but once one has been introduced to this example, everyone grasps the wider implications and the ubiquity of the phenomenon of values in design. Other studies into the philosophy and sociology of technology, so-called science and technology studies, STS research, in the 80s have also revealed numerous illustrations and detailed case studies of the fact that social and political biases, especially those to do with race, gender, and income, could be inscribed in technical artifacts, systems, and infrastructures. Jeff Bowker, Susan Lee Starr, and Lucy Suchman have contributed much to this work. Some specialized areas of design and engineering in the 80s also started to use this basic design for values or value-sensitive design idea concretely. Two examples may serve as an illustration. First, privacy-enhancing technology. In the 80s, a number of privacy scholars started to work on ways to design IT systems and applications in such a way that the likelihood that users would comply with privacy norms would increase. Instead of relying on the goodwill of users to comply with privacy regulations, the artifacts themselves would make it more probable that they would be in compliance. Secondly, in the 80s, in architecture and the built environment studies in architectural design and urban planning, there were ideas to design against crime and design for security. Lighting, variety in architecture, spacing between buildings, lines of sight, were all found to be important in the design against crime. The most clear and precise formulation of this idea can be found in a movement originated at Stanford in the 1980s and 70s in computer science in the work of Terry Winograd. It has now been adopted by many research groups and it is often referred to as value-sensitive design. Value-sensitive design is an approach to systems development and software engineering which was developed in the last decade of the 20th century. It was developed by Batya Friedman and others, building on insights of the human-computer interaction community and to draw attention to the social and moral dimensions of design. In value-sensitive design, the focus is on incorporating a wide range of human and moral values into design of information technology and any technology for that matter. Even though value-sensitive design doesn't commit to a specific normative framework, according to Friedman, value-sensitive design is primarily concerned with values that center on human well-being, human dignity, justice, welfare, and human rights. Value-sensitive design connects the people who design systems and interfaces with the people who think about and understand the values of the stakeholders who are affected by the systems. To quote Friedman, ultimately, value-sensitive design requires that we broaden the goals and criteria for judging the quality of technological systems to include those that advance human values. And a definition I've used in 2004 is that value-sensitive design is a way of doing ethics that aims at making moral values part of technological design, research, and development. The main methodological structure used by value-sensitive design initiatives is an integrative and iterative tripartite methodology consisting of conceptual, empirical, and technical investigations. each of these conceptual, empirical, and technical investigations and analysis are carried out iteratively, mutually informing and being informed by the other investigations. Value-sensitive design has a number of features that are defining of responsible innovation. Values and moral concerns of all concerned need to be articulated when they can still make a difference to design. They need to be formulated in such a way that they can inform design. And designs and artifacts need to be evaluated in terms of the values and moral concerns. It may be clear that although value-sensitive design developed in the field of information technology and computer science, it has a much wider purchase and is relevant to all innovation and design of new technology and technological artifacts. And how this will be done in detail will be the subject of our next web lecture. Thank you for your attention.